I want to talk to you about Easter. Easter is Sunday. It's a very, very, very special holiday. Last week we talked about Palm Sunday. It kind of leads us up to Easter. And we're going to start our story where the disciples and Jesus are coming into Jerusalem to celebrate Passover together. And we're going to be in Matthew 26. So if you want to find your Bibles and turn to that chapter, we're going to start there and go through the Easter story together.
So let's start Matthew 26, verses 3 to 5. Then the chief priests and the elders of the people assembled in the palace of the high priest, whose name was Caiaphas, and they schemed to arrest Jesus secretly and kill him.
Those high priests, they were so interested in their own self-gain and their influence and how much power they had that they totally missed Jesus.
So let's continue our story in Matthew 26. We'll start with verse 14. Then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12 disciples, went to the leading priests and asked, "How much will you pay me to betray Jesus to you?" And they gave him 30 pieces of silver. From that time on, Judas began looking for an opportunity to betray Jesus. Jesus then sat down with his disciples for the Passover meal. He surprised the disciples by washing their feet. He was teaching them and teaching us that it is far more important and a higher calling to serve unto others, to be a servant. Matthew 26, verse 20. When it was evening, Jesus sat down at the table with the 12. While they were eating, he said, "I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me." Let's continue our story, Matthew 26, verse 26.
"This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you. A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if ye have love one to another." Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I came forth from the Father and am come into the world. Again I leave the world and go to the Father. These things I have spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world.
Wow. Jesus was telling the disciples to love as he loved them, that he was going to go back to his Father. He came from heaven and he was going back to heaven, but not to worry, to have peace, that he would be always there for them.
Matthew 26, verse 47. And even as Jesus said this, Judas, one of the 12 disciples, arrived with a crowd of men armed with swords and clubs that had been sent by the leading priests and elders of the people. The traitor Judas had given them a prearranged signal. "You will know which one to arrest when I greet him with a kiss." So Judas came straight to Jesus. "Greetings, Rabbi," he explained, and gave him a kiss. Jesus said, "My friend, go ahead and do what you've come for." Then the others grabbed Jesus and arrested him. Matthew 27, verse 11. Now Jesus was standing before Pilate, the Roman governor, Are you the king of Jews? The governor asked him. Jesus replied, You have said it. But when the leading priests and elders made their accusations against him, Jesus remained silent. Don't you hear all these charges they are bringing against you? Pilate demanded. But Jesus made no response to any of the charges, much to the governor's surprise. Now it was the governor's custom each year during Passover celebration to release one prisoner to the crowd, anyone they wanted. This year, there was a notorious prisoner, a man named Barabbas. As the crowds gathered before Pilate's house, that morning, he asked them, Which one do you want me to release, Barabbas or Jesus, who was called the Messiah? He knew very well that the religious leaders had arrested Jesus out of envy. Now we're at verse 21. So the governor asked again, Which of these two do you want me to release to you? The crowd shouted back, Barabbas! Pilate responded, Then what shall I do with this Jesus you call Messiah? They shouted back, Crucify him. Why? Pilate demanded. What crime has he committed? But the mob roared even louder, Crucify him. Jesus was severely beaten, mocked, spit on, and he was hung to the cross. He was crucified. But guys, that's not where the story ends. Easter isn't about Jesus' crucifixion. It's about what happens next. So the high priest was so worried that Jesus would do as he said, rise again, come back to life. So they put guards at his tomb, watching day and night to make sure nothing happened. Matthew 28. Early on Sunday morning, as the new day was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went out to visit the tomb. Suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, rolled aside the stone, and sat on it. His face shone like lightning, and his clothing was as white as snow. The guards shook with fear when they saw him, and they fell into a dead faint. Then the angel spoke to the woman. Don't be afraid, he said. I know you're looking for Jesus who was crucified. He isn't there. He is risen from the dead, just as he said would happen. Come, see where his body is lying. And now, go quickly and tell the disciples that he has risen from the dead and he is going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. Remember what I have told you. The woman ran quickly from the tomb. They were frightened, but also filled with great joy. And they rushed to give the disciples the angel's message. And as they went, Jesus met them and greeted them. And they ran to him, grasped his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, Don't be afraid. Go tell my brothers to leave for Galilee, and they will see me there.
Well, that, my friends, that's the story of Easter. And the big part of the story is that God loves you so much that he had his son come down to earth to teach us, to love on us, but then to go through that death for us. We didn't spend a lot of time talking about it. But you get it, right? He was nailed to a cross. He was spit at. He was tortured. He did that because he loves us. He loves you and he loves me that much. And because he did that, he sacrificed. That gives us freedom. We're his kids. We have freedom. We can make mistakes. We can get forgiven. We don't have to try to be perfect. Because Jesus did that for us, because he loves us that much.